Welcome back, everybody, to the ISO Cup. We are getting into the finals here, where two different teams came all the way from the qualifiers to be here in the finals in a best of three up against each other. Spin to Win versus Immortal Mode On. I still got the name. Anyway, guys, real quick, we're going to give a shout-out, of course. The ISO Cup is sponsored by ISO, would you believe it? And they are an awesome sponsor. They are the ones who make this whole entire thing happen. So amateur teams, Tier 2, Tier 3 teams actually have the opportunity to be able to get some money in their hands and also get a chance to shine here on the ISO Cup platform. So be sure to go support them. We have the ISO Forest FS2434, a really great monitor, as you saw from the promo we played just before we started this. It's got a lot of awesome features, such as an IPS panel with vivid and consistent colors. It's got a zero delay gaming with extremely low input lag. It also has ultra slim frames, 6 millimeters. Basically, you stack like three of those together. That means more screen and less border, I guess is what you call it. And of course, you can also master the game with the smart features that come with the monitor: Smart Insight 2, Smart Resolution, and Smart Detection. So let's jump into our first game of the day, our first game of this finals, rather, as I welcome in my co-caster, Rio Burrows. What's up, Rio?
What's up? All I wanted to say during that time was sell, and then the other word, but
out.
Still, it was nice.
Was the other word out?
No. Salesman. You're a salesman, dude.
Just yeah, I'm that. I do that. It's awesome. Anyway, Spin to Win versus Immortal Mode On, who didn't put their team name on. So
I was going to ask you.
It's going to be a little hard for us to remember that.
Immortal Mode On, dude. Yeah, I got this. I got it.
Just think their logo is an Aegis. Immortality. Yeah. Immortal. Yep.
But it's fine. It's fine. All right, I wanted to ask you, who do you think is going to win this? Is it 2-1, 2-0? What do you think?
I think it's 2-0 to Immortal Mode On.
I was going to say the same thing. You're copying me, dude.
Me and you, man. We're on the same wavelength. We're on the same wavelength. Let's talk about the draft because it's almost over. Witch Doctor, Clockwork, Wind Ranger, and Drow Ranger. I do like this lineup from Spin to Win, so maybe I'll change my prediction. But Earthshaker, Juggernaut, Queen of Pain, and Brewmaster, well, looking at that lineup, actually, they actually have a lot of gap closers to some very fragile heroes on the side of Spin to Win. You may have a lot of DPS coming out from Spin to Win with a Witch Doctor, a Wind Ranger, and a Drow Ranger all coupled together, but those are also heroes that falter under direct line of fire in these tankier gap closers, such as Juggernaut, Queen of Pain, Brewmaster, and even the Earthshaker later on to the game are going to prove to be quite potent versus the Spin to Win team.
Yeah, I'm really interested to see, is it the Brew offlane with Lich, or is it Lich, Queen of Pain off, Brew mid, and maybe Juggernaut solo? Okay. Actually, maybe Jug, Lich offlane, bottom is Queen of Pain, Brew mid. Could be what I... Well, no, never mind. All right. Well, I'm just going to stop predicting lanes because, yeah, Queen of Pain's going mid already. But yeah. I love their lineup right now. I thought they would pick up Rubick to counteract the Enigma, but instead going for the Lich counter. So, I don't know. They have two things to cancel Black Hole. Lich ulti and Juggernaut ulti. So, I'm kind of liking their odds here. And it's been to win playing too greedy in this first game with the jungler and Enigma. What do you think?
I think that Spin to Win are definitely playing too greedy with the Enigma. I think that they needed some sort of early aggression from their supports to be able to give them an advantage in the laning phase and like snowball that very rapidly with tower pushing and everything else. I don't think they needed a pusher in Enigma to be able to utilize the Drow Ranger aura. Like, that's good enough for pushing. I think they just needed more sustainability, which technically the Enigma does offer with mech. But I think they needed to be able to just get themselves like early aggression on the round the map, getting pickoffs and winning the laning phase, winning top, winning middle, maybe even a rotation all the way down to bottom lane. And yeah, sorry, Cart. Immortal Mode On is the name of the other team. yeah. Unfortunately, the in-game lobby has been broken, so it's been kind of difficult to get some of these games going and remind the teams, hey, you have to use your logo, you know, that kind of thing, because the in-game lobby chat has been broken all evening long. So shout out to Dota 2.
Well, we're going to be seeing some interesting lanes coming out here. Dual lanes, I expected. So this will be giving Clockwork what he wants, free lane, as well as the Witch Doc or the Enigma free jungle. So getting your two big playmakers in the game, a good start is could be enough for Spin to win in this early game, but... middle lane so far. Queen of Pain's pretty much dominating Windrunner right now, I'd say. Just
it shouldn't happen for
it
shouldn't happen for too long just because Mr. Ling has a Drow Ranger aura that should give you the advantage. But Queen of Pain does have a really good start. Really good attack damage in the first couple levels. It's one of her biggest advantages as a mid laner, right?
Yeah. She still haven't used her nuke though, which is surprising. She's just going for the trying to lane dominate, but now she's getting kind of returned on. So this is basically an even mid matchup here, and both teams, well, mid top lane, Cybernet is gonna go down here.
Yeah, Cass bouncing around, last hits, and he does end up dying. So I'm not sure why they were so far forward, but they end up getting caught and feed away a kill. First blood, in fact, to the Drow Ranger. Not the kind of start you're looking for. Again, I'm looking to be able to see that Spin to Win establish lane dominance if they want to be able to win with this very squishy Drow Ranger, Wind Ranger core that they've got going on. They're going to go on Fringe now. Cybernet still unable to do anything. Where's his leveling blast? He only just now gets it, turns around onto Byver, slowing him down finally, but that was very odd. The rotation in from the Earthshaker, is it going to be enough? He's got a Fissure, but Fringe actually stops running forward. And now full aggro tri-lane, I guess, which leads the Clockwork 1v1 up against the Juggernaut, which is fine by him.
And he's going spin mode. Well, Clockwork has boots on him, so using that spin really early there, it's not looking too good for their offlane now. So, yeah, feeding a kill over, not having clap on Panda, having this ward in a really weird spot, not having for the Radiant side, not spotting out which deck to rotation. Kind of questioning this early game from coming in from my mortal. Oh my gosh.
Immortal mode on, yeah. I agree. I agree. I'm questioning what they're doing as well. I don't think they have a firm grasp on this laning phase at all. I think that generally they. I mean, the Earthshaker Juggernaut lane wasn't going to be that good anyway, do you think? I don't know, I thought they would just like run basically defensive tri-lane with the Earthshaker like starting off. Like maybe they start off with a block off and a deny in the top lane, but they still zone the Clockwork out because he's such an effective hero.
So the perfect lane setup would have been Quap bottom against Clock, you wreck Clockwork there in that
true.
Situation. You put Brew mid, which trades off really easily against Wind Ranger. Because you have the misses in the clap that you can push out lane. Top lane, though.
Yeah, they're going to get the clap here onto the Drow Ranger. Fortunately, she does have boots. Sharfeek miss in out. Well, he actually doesn't have Aftershock, so he's actually just trying to use Enchant Totem and does get the kill because of it. Byver. Yeah, the boots first Earthshaker managing to secure the kill.
No.
Looks like he's going to be going for the Trinx and Soul Ring build under Shaker rather than trying to bank on some early arcanes. Mid lane, 16-8 on King R, 12-6 on our Wind Ranger. Pretty even matchup so far.
Yeah, I would say Queen Pain doing a little bit better here. Rune contest here. This is going to be a 3v2 scenario.
Is Sharfeek doesn't get off the stun. The Malphite's holding him in. A bit surprising, but the stun does still come out. Byver is going to die to King R, who now has that double damage to be able to wreck the Enigma possibly as well. Needs some extra help. The power shot or shackle shot doesn't land, and Sogard will end up falling. King R now bottling up, can actually blink forward onto the Wind Ranger. Oh, God. Why doesn't she have Wind Run? King R slowed down. This time the power shot does land. They're going to try and turn it around. King R can actually fight Byver here. This is not the fight you can win, my friend. What in the world? Maledict is only level 1. Why did you think it was level 4 or something?
Well, we saw this last time. What happens when a freaking their mid lane carries them with Storm Spirit?
Yeah.
It might happen again this game. So, King R showing why he's... could be a good up-and-coming player here, but...
yeah, why he's the mid laner as opposed to Sharfeek.
Yeah.
Why he plays
Jolem.
Storm Spirit.
Stop.
Yeah, blocked out by the Fissure. Nicely played. And another clap. Give him the clap, Fringe. Give him the clap. Lich picks up the last hit. And can now get himself boots as well.
Man, look at the CS, though. Clockwork leading so much right now. He's got level 6. Poor Jug only has level 5. This could be a dive, but no.
Just burn some more mana. But at this point, like, Butch, especially with the bottle that he has, he could easily, if in my mind, I'm setting that Cogs up to be able to go on the Juggernaut. Like, bottle up, hit the hook shot, Battery Assault, run him down because he doesn't have mana for spin, so Battery Assault is fully effective. But he doesn't choose to go for that route. Instead, it's just continuing to control the lane and keep the Juggernaut back rather than actively looking for the kill.
He's got max rocket, which is kind of weird. I guess he's assuming that the jug spin would be too much for him to handle, but max rocket, I don't really agree with this. You only need really 2 or 3 points in it if you really want to last it. But
yeah.
I don't think he has enough kill potential now. I guess just thinking, all right, there's going to be a panda with split. You have spin from Juggernaut, as well as the Queen of Pain with Blink. It's going to be useless, but you still have Shackle Shots. You still got some good stuns, Black Hole, and, well, even if you pick off Earth Spirit or Lich or Earthshaker and
Fiddlestead. Sharfik?
He doesn't have...
Why didn't King R blink forward? Hit the slow.
He doesn't have his ulti, and I don't know what's going on in this game. Queen of Pain doesn't have ulti, and...
I think that's kind of acceptable, right? I mean, Sonic Wave is pretty heavy cost. Top lane, they are going to be able to get a clap. Jolem slowed down as well as Byver. Cybernet comes forward. They do get a nice Fissure. Trying to go for Byver here at the same time. Jolem's going to be slowed down by that. They will be able to right-click him down. Nope, the Silence bounced back. Jolem still kept alive by his Tango hits, but not good enough. Meanwhile, King R comes in, gets the Witch Doctor kill, and they won't actually go for the Enigma, surprisingly enough. Maybe out of fear of the black hole underneath the tower, but... they will back up 7-2 now in the favor of Immortal Mode on.
Why would you not get a Queen of Pain ulti? Is it just too much mana? Because you
I think so.
Yeah, I guess you could say you're only getting about... What is it?
I mean, with this build, this sort of like a lane domination and mana to damage efficient, right? I mean, if you're going to use Scream of Pain anyway... the increased cost, 10 extra mana for 75 extra damage. And Sonic Wave, like, chances are you're not going to be able to use both of these abilities most of the time. And unless you go back to base or you get a regeneration rune, since you're constantly spamming on main, and the bottom lane's going to die.
I saw you were looking at it, so there was no point in talking about it. Just pretty good dive coming out, and that's what they need. Clockwork has to be their big playmaker, as well as this Enigma, because they're the only two that are getting real free farm in this game.
Yeah. So hopefully the Clockwork and Enigma are able to, I mean, the greediness of the Enigma pickup, hopefully it turns out for them to be able to get some good black holes or something, because as it stands right now, it's... They just don't have enough control to actually use their pushing abilities. They've got this Wind Ranger, Drought Ranger combo, which is really nice, and they've got the Enigma as well, who gets a big increase out of the Enigma, but or out of the Drought Ranger aura, but you know, it means nothing essentially if you can't actively push in and win fights in the first place.
Right. Well, they're trying to set up another kill here and, well, finally get some rotations coming in for the Radiant side. Will they be in there in time? He's pinging out. He knows they're there, but is he going to die before his allies get there? This could be really good for Immortal and Modon right here.
Yeah, they Fissure gets it. Oh, Chain Frost is going to bounce around as well. They lock down Sogard pretty easily. Let's see what else they can get. Butch is going to TP out successfully. Byver. Has the same hopes, but he's got mana issues, so he's going to go down as well, as I'm sure. Somebody's going to catch up to him. Maiden just, Omni Slash, whatever. Gets the kill, and they'll take down the
Oh, no.
Fringe is forced to pop the ultimate, but without the slow of the clap, Jolem's just going to be able to run himself away for the most part. Why is he cycloning?
Why is he not, casting his wind pant? Okay.
All right, now he cyclones, so he did something, but he doesn't have mana. He actually had to cyclone the Drought Ranger to survive, otherwise, jump on the bottom lane. The ward actually does die here. Main turns and fights Butch as best as possible, but unfortunately he will still be run down by the battery zone.
And the mid tower went down for spin to win. So they might be down 5 kills right now, but they're not losing out on the gold right now. It's going in the side of them just because Clockwork and Enigma CS in this game. So,
and the tower advantage going their way as well. So who knows? Maybe they can actually get some push out of these heroes. Enigma's now going to join the clockwork here in the bottom lane. Clockwork 10, level 10 by 10 minutes. Again, like most heroes should not be able to keep up the one level per minute past like level 8 at most. So if you're 9x9, 10x10, 11x11, you are seriously dominating the game. You must be getting a lot of kills because there's no way that should be happening.
Yeah, it's more so when you get these solo kills on the same levels, then you just get instant level up, level and a half.
Yeah.
Poor Drow though.
Thank you. Yeah. Caught out again, Cybernet double slow, the bounce back, and the... Nope, they can't actually get him. TP out, the Fisher unfortunately put Fringe on the wrong side and wasn't able to get the critical hit he needed to finish that off. Butch looking for a hook shot. Not actually going to make the jump here. The Brewmaster didn't have his ultimate, so I think they could have tried to just go. With the Enigma pushing forward, a black hole, and the hook shot on somebody a bit farther forward, I think that would have been an excellent opportunity to force a fight.
Yeah, they had TP's though on the Jug and Queen of Pain. It could have been a bad fight if they didn't kill Butch.
Yeah, Butch is probably going to die here. Sharfeek running him down, and King R will actually be the one claiming the last hit. Speaking of him, Orchid is going to be his item choice, and he'll have it pretty quickly at this rate. 6-0-1, a highest net worth on the board. It's sitting at 6K.
That's pretty good for him. Getting a fast Orchid, that's what you need in this game. And, well, Clockwork going for that. I wonder if he's going to go the same build as we saw Gideon last game. Four staff into blade mail. I don't think that's what you want to get at all this game. Definitely not a blade mail game in my opinion.
Yeah.
But we'll see if he wants to do the same thing.
Blink Brewmaster adds a lot of power to that here. Hopefully they'll make some space for our Juggernaut, who's way down in the net worth board right now. He is sitting at 2,800 net worth by 12 minutes in. That is a grand total of below 250 gold per minute. So they got to give some Juggernaut some space to get back into this game. Witch Doctor gets picked off in the top lane. They'll get the tier 1 tower. So there's some added gold for the Juggernaut if they get this tower.
Well, here comes more added gold for Spin to win. Roshan going to be taken out. And I don't know if I agree putting it on the Drow Ranger. I would probably put it on the Clock. Or
the Wind Ranger, maybe?
Wind Ranger, yeah. I don't know. She just dies way too fast. I guess you could say, yeah, she's going to be dying the whole time, so she needs two lives, but I guess you could say having... What's a cooldown on Gus? Gus is 13? You could maybe get two of them off in a team fight, which can always turn the team fight around. These silences, if you can get them off on a hookshot target and they don't go out of the cogs or something, then it's good. Then the Brewmaster might want to get off split. And if Brew doesn't get off his split, then the team fight for me should be won. Unless the Earthshaker has a blink, but he doesn't right now. So.
Drow Ranger said, I've actually never seen it. I saw a little bit of fuss on Reddit once about the icons. But the set itself is not overly flashy, but it's an interesting idea.
It's just that she's giving off like frozen aspects, the frost, the chill.
Yeah. Is under attack. Tier 2 tower in the bottom lane, about to fall because immortal mode on, still haven't yet. Oh, Brewmaster actually gets a nice jump. He didn't try and clap, and that's the wise decision. Otherwise, he would have been silenced up. Gets the opportunity to control some of these heroes, going for Jolum while also throwing up the Cyclone. Oh, Butch actually misses the hookshot. The rest of the team, though, unable to find any real good grass. King R's got a great opportunity for an ultimate. Lits and loose. It's not going to finish off any one hero. They're all low, though. John's going to come in. He's going to be able to clean up one, two, and there goes a third with the Aegis. Fringe coming back in. Clap. No! Nice force staff from Butch. Jolum comes back. Secondary life of Drow Ranger is going to be an utter failure. Triple kill for Maiden. And great initiation there from Queen of Pain. Seeing the opportunity. Not able to finish off a single hero herself, but essentially won the fight single-handedly with that combo of her ultimate and Scream of Pain.
Yeah, just really well played by Queen of Pain there, setting up the team fight. Enigma did TP out. I wonder if that could have been a play around, maybe to a 3 or 4-man black hole, but they really didn't have their DPS in that team fight. You need the Witch Doctor ulti. You kind of need more at that time. as well Radiant's as the Wind Ranger, so attack. I could understand why they wanted to bail out, but it could have been a great turnaround black hole. Instead, it's just we'll be wondering if it was enough, but.
All right. Well, Main is going to get back into this game thanks to those three kills that he got, plus a little bit of jungle farm for him constantly. You see him climbing the ranks of the net worth board, now only sitting fourth, a little bit behind the Enigma. Queen of Pain's got the Orchid.
Is it Ags on Jug? Or what would you want to see?
I haven't seen an Ags Juggernaut in quite a long time.
Yeah.
Why do you think that was such a thing for so long?
You know, to be honest, I'm not exactly sure. I guess they just really wanted more hits off in their Omni Slash.
Yeah.
But I don't know. That's the way the Mask of Madness mid lane, though.
Orchid on Butch. He's trying to run down Cybernet. Up. Force Staff will actually get him in range. Fringe also going to die. Unable to get the last hit on the tower. The worst thing possible for Immortal Mode. They suicide on the tower. Can't even get the last hit.
Yeah, and that's the return here now. When you have these heroes down, they have buyback. No buyback on Brew. He bought a Arcane Boot. 129. That was in January. So, yeah, I just think that the biggest problem for Juggernauts now is just trying to get enough lockdown, get enough attacks in your spending. That Mask of Madness does it. You don't really need to have the eggs anymore. And then you just want to slow down enemies, permabash them too. And well, I would still like to see, you know, sometimes a Battle Fury. So if you're dealing with Illusion Heroes or a Mjolnir or something, because we saw last game, there was an Axe in the game. He got some 3 or 4 man calls. It's just the Lina was not there all the time and it was no AoE.
Right.
And when you have these four heroes grouped up, the Omni Slash, even if you have a Sanjin Yasha and Mask Madness, they just tank it up so easily.
Yasha to be finished up by the Dro Ranger. We have
Radiant's bottom tower. Set up.
Oh, Tranquil Boots for the Witch Doctor. I was like, does he have a Force Staff already? Wow. No. Not even close. Not even
no
close.
No Earthshaker.
Clockwork is going to be gone. Yeah, Earthshaker is dead.
Get.
Clockwork's
going
to be gone for the Axe build instead of Plague Mail.
Yeah, this Clockwork's definitely putting in some work now into this game. He might have died one time, but still. I don't know. I think he's going to carry. King R versus Mr. Ling. Is under attack. No, nothing's going to be had.
No fights anywhere. Maybe Butch could be found if he sticks around for too long. Force Staff TP out. He is good. Chain Frost wasn't going to be there in time for the mini stun. So S and Y soon for Jolim. He's got a full out pipe for the Enigma with the mech. That definitely gives them a lot more sustainability. That was kind of the biggest problem I saw for this team, so the pipes are definitely a great pickup.
Yeah, King R just missed a kill, free kill on Drow. Got the gust off before the Orchid could go, and Fushi, I got the scream. That would have been enough for the Sonic Wave, but unfortunate. And well, they're gonna need King R to get this Ags pretty fast, cause I'm seeing a death push coming down the mid lane here soon, or the bottom, after they get their Roshan. So they either need to contest Roshan or kind of wait it out for Ags Quap. I want to see what they decide to do.
Farming up Ancients together. Spin to win. I agree with you. I think we're going to be seeing like just a five-man death push, essentially. It's just now waiting for Spin to win to farm up while they wait for Roshan, get those next set of items. Do you think you need BKB, or is the pipe good enough for the Drow Ranger?
I would like to see. Yeah, I would like to see her to finish it too, but if you have the Aegis and the pipe and mech, I think it really is enough. Just because you're going to have this Witch Doctor and Clockwork doing a lot in these team fights, I think. Because you don't have a BKB on Queen of Pain, you don't have a BKB on Jug. You can take out one hero from the team fights with Panda, but.
Power shot reveals Maiden. They get the silence on him. Oh, echo slam. Sharpie glanted on three. The mech comes out, but it's futile, my friend. Spin to win. Just got put in the dumpster. Holy cow. Four kills. Double kill for King R. Double for Maiden. All right, never mind. There goes Spin to Win's game.
Yep.
GG to Immortal Mode on.
Pretty much. That's
like actually one of those game losing fights.
Yeah, it's like you see it at, we saw them at TI3 all the time when like Darkseer gets a vacuum into like an Echo Slam or tanky multi. It's just, there's nothing you can do. Oh man. Beautiful initiation coming out, and that's a tier 2. But you could say that's a bad thing now, because they didn't get any Raxes, so now all they have to do for Spin to Win is maybe wait out Roche, and unfortunately it's only going to be a 3-minute respawn here. Maybe if it was a little bit closer in the next minute to respawn, that would be nice for them. But
double damage.
Yeah, the problem I see with that is like by the time they're ready to go and push in, Maiden's like made a full recovery. He's the Juggernaut. He is above.
Yeah.
Actually, the Windranger and Drow Ranger are god awful farm now. After those deaths, considering they're the 1 and 2 positions, and like Clockwork and Enigmar are still outdoing them in net worth quite heavily. Sharfik, jump over to left side. Butch, where's the hook shot? What the hell? Did they not see what just happened? All right. Well then, nice dodge, I guess, by Sharfik.
I don't know, man. This is looking weird. Weird stuff going on right now. Well, we called it though. We thought they would be doing well. I mean, it's just, it's been to win. They might have been down kills this whole game, but still they've been applying a lot more pressure on the map. So if I see another pause in my game, I'm gonna.
Yeah.
I don't know what I'm gonna do.
Yeah.
What am I gonna do, Cap? What am I gonna do?
You're gonna scream. Just do some.
You know, I have
screaming.
A dramatic. I have a laugh.
You have a laugh. Congratulations. Most of us
have
that.
I have two laughs that are different, and. They're unique and special. He wants me to do it. I don't know, man. There's too much pressure now. You have to say something funny at least, Cart. All right, give me a joke, Cart. Give me a joke. Give me one. Better be good.
Yeah, where's my joke? Go, Cart. Why can't orphans play baseball?
God, this is going to be...
Because they don't have a home.
Really mean. They don't have a home.
Yeah,
oh yeah, they don't have a home, man.
They don't know where home is. Yeah, somewhere. Something about home. I was like, I knew what I said wasn't quite right, but it had something to do with home plate. All right, don't. Oh my God, don't do that. That is awful. Why would you do
that,
Rio?
Wait, I'm a chipmunk.
Why would
Come
you
on,
do
man.
That? That sounds awful.
What are you talking?
That was actually the most disturbing thing I've ever heard in my life.
I'm chipmunkle, dude.
No, that's not even a chipmunk. What? That's actually like.
All right, I have the other one. It's worse, but I don't want to do this.
Oh God, it's worse. Describe it to me first.
It's like the Wicked Witch of the West.
No. If it goes like that was the thing. I was like, if it goes even more high pitched.
Yes.
I do not want to hear it. What the hell, Ryu? Are we good? Why the hell are we paused?
Isn't there a player DC still, dude? Jeez, relax, man.
All right, whatever. I'm just saying, communication is key.
Communication, open your eyes.
Yeah.
Blind.
Amazon just got permission from the FAA to start testing its delivery drones in the U.S. Oh my God.
What do you call a group of unorganized cats, Ryu?
A catastrophe.
Catastrophe. Oh. He really wants me to use my other voice. Hell no.
Apparently, Pipmunkle just like. Ranted to everybody. He called out Twitch chat.
You know, I want to do that laugh one day when there's like 20,000 people watching and just watch Twitch chat just flame the shit out of me.
All you want to do is see the world burn. Why did the bicycle fall over?
I don't know.
Because it was too tired. Oh, damn it.
Oh, damn. That's a good
one. I was actually trying to think of it. I was like, it's something you do with two. I was saying wheels in my head.
Wheels, too.
I was trying to make some
man.
Sort of wheel pun. I was like, oh, what is it? What is it? Too tired.
I was just thinking like the wheels on the bus.
Wheels on the bus go round and round. Round and round.
I'm listening to the cast again where I'm listening to you say it was the most disturbing thing you ever said. Heard. We call it alligator in a vest. What the hell? A vest? In a vest? Investigator.
All right, I don't know about that one. It's not as good.
Yeah, these jokes are definitely slacking right now, but we won't even need them anymore.
I just want to laugh. No, don't make him do the laugh. All right,
here we go, guys.
Those are two dad jokes.
Wait.
What?
Wait. What? When the game starts, I'll do it.
No. No, don't do it. I'm gonna mute you.
Why not? Why?
I will mute you.
But it's the best.
Listen, Rio. If your mother was a Dota hero, that would make Pudge the second fattest hooker in the game.
Dang. Well, nobody can fit in your mom's black hole anymore.
Why are Americans so bad at playing Dota?
Why couldn't the Sesame Seed?
Oh my god, they're bad at defending towers. That one's actually awful. That one's actually
NA
awful.
NA Dota. It's Divide. True though, NA Dota sucks at defending towers.
NA Dota just sucks in general.
They trade like one tier, one for...
Listen, Ryu, can you actually convince one North American team to stick together for more than 2 months?
You know, I did that. I was doing that. I was the role model for NA Dota. I sucked it up. I played with Team E-Hug. You know, I did it.
And then you left.
Yeah, well, you understood. Okay, so it was get to TI5 by caster or by not.
Uh-huh.
It was the only way.
Wait, you did go to TI, huh? I forgot about that.
Yeah, man, I forgot too. I wasn't even there, man.
Yeah. So you chose wisely, as the old guy in Indiana Jones would say.
Did I though? Did I? I only got to cast games with you, man. I don't know if it was worth it. And then Wagamama
you didn't cast with me.
I know. And then Wagamama stole me. Well, like we casted together for like I don't know 60 or 70 games. And then Waga stole you from me for TI.
Yeah.
What the hell, man?
He was one of the Knights of the Cross. That's all I know. I don't know his name. Anyway, what were we talking about? Oh yeah. Well, I mean, you got. Listen, you actually got way more exposure and screen time out of being on the desk than you would as a caster. So that's good at least.
Well, you can't really put yourself out there. You can't just say like, hey, follow me here, follow me there. And
yeah,
stuff.
But they did pop up graphics, right?
No, they didn't.
And stuff. Social media?
No.
Really?
No.
Well, I mean, still got more FaceTime, I guess.
True. Everybody knows who I am, at least. Yeah. I'm Matt Damon. So I guess it's better just to be recognized than to be famous, you know? It's fine. I don't care.
Could you say Matt Damon all over? Matt Damon. Matt Damon. Matt Damon. Smoke up, we're going to have an initiation onto King R, who's silenced up. Oh dear, nice Fisher interception though. Echo Slam onto two. Omni Slash bouncing around, is going to be able to finish off Butch. Sharfik has no escape, but it doesn't seem to matter with the Brewmaster here. They will be able to control most of the heroes. Unfortunately, Earshaker is going to die eventually. The ultimate comes out from King R, but the pipe does protect them. For the most part, Main's still trying to beat down some of these heroes, but between the mech and the pipe, added a serious amount of survivability to these heroes. Sogard, oh no! Silence up after the black hole. The orchid right on the money. And Mr. Ling, haste or no, is going to be forced back by another poison. Cybernet barely survived there. I think he survived with, what, like 10 HP or something. And right back to Roshan. Spin to win. Couldn't intercept that one. And Immortal Mode on will, in fact, get themselves some immortality.
Yeah, that team fight top lane is really setting them back down. BKB not on Enigma is really costing them in these team fights, as well as this Earthshaker is making some huge plays. So Charfiga has definitely been a beast right now, and he just keeps on delivering. Well, yay, Queen of Pain ulti, level 16 with an axe, and 32,000 gold boot. 32,000, yeah. 3,200. Well, about the same, I would say.
Yeah, I mean, 32,000 just means you can pretty much be 6 slotted. 3,200 means that you can get halfway to a luxury item. But you're right, it's totally the same.
Oh, yeah.
What does he go, by the way? Scythe of Ice?
Wait, does he need a BKB this game? I'm not exactly sure. I mean, there's
the Silence of the Drow Ranger that's kind of obnoxious, plus Shackle Shot, so I wouldn't blame him if he went BKB.
I mean, you saw that team fight start off with it. It's just the amazing fissure that came in afterwards that really saved him there. Else he would have been silenced for the whole fight and might have went down. You know, I'm just done calling items this game. Oh, King Art.
Yeah, there it is. Hey, oh, we're right about an item winner, for once. BKB, I'm Queen of Pain. Good thing no one's watching and they can't criticize us for always being wrong about the items. BKB soon on the Juggernaut. We do have 1,500 gold on our Brewmaster, who will probably, I guess, be building into an Assault Kiras. This is his next item.
Or yeah, BKB. That or BKB, too. Yeah. But let's
again,
guess it now.
If he feels necessary. I don't know. You choose one, I'll choose the other. That way we can't both be wrong.
All right, I'm going to say Force Staff.
All right, I'm going to say BKB.
All right. We'll see who's
now
right.
What? Now watch. They're going to win a fight, and he's going to have so much gold, he's going to be like, well, I have to go Assault Kiras now.
Yeah.
He's going to be like, I've got 4K gold. Of course I go Assault Kiras. Yeah, BKB for Brewmaster. Deal with the silence.
That's Force Staff. Y'all are all wrong. You don't know what... I'm next leveling this right now.
Force Staff. If you're right, I will...
What will you do? What will you do? No, you have to say it.
I'll do something drastic.
Alright, Stream Nake. Oh, you'll get banned. Do an Obnoxious Laugh too. Yeah, you have to do that too.
Fine, I'll do an Obnoxious Laugh. I don't even know what I would do, but it's not going to be a Force Staff, so.
It'd be like something stupid like, Mwah!
I'll do the Count Laugh.
You have to demonstrate first.
Oh, I don't have to because there's no Force Staff on Brewmaster yet.
I was testing. Didn't work.
Yeah. Testing my ass. Dry Ranger trying to go for a BKB. Got away. Oh! Alright. Sharfik kind of messes that one up. Still hits the Echo Slam stun. Fringe will be able to get close enough to make sure that Sharfik does not die. And King R is just like, middle finger to both of you. I'm taking this kill.
That's just rude. He didn't even need that. He could have just screamed at pain.
He really could have, but he was like, no. I must be able to establish my dominance. Brewmaster could have a four staff right now.
Top tower is under attack. He's saving.
I'm just going to point it out.
He's saving. He's thinking about it. He's listening to the cast, waiting for it to catch up with me. Top tower is under attack. I mean, the one thing that Spin to Win have is, yes, if they get all five of their heroes BKBs, then you could be in a really good position. It'll negate Brewmaster, ulti, Earthshaker, well, missing kills left and right. But yeah, Clockwork definitely needs one, Wind Ranger needs one, they practically all can get one, and then that's where I see maybe it helping. You still have the pure damage coming in from Queen of Pain, as well as the ulti coming in from Jug, but everything else will be negated, so.
But it's Brewmaster, 200 gold.
You really just want to see him buy the... He's not going BKB. We said it already. He's just going to win this next team fight and buy Assault, man. It's going
to
happen.
It's actually what's going to happen. All because you chose to say Force Staff instead of AC or BKB. All because of you. A Brew has never followed up a Blink and Vlance with Force. Blink and Vlance has been followed up by AC 106 times.
I need to message this guy right now. I need to add him real quick. Hopefully he adds during game.
All right. Well, they lost Juggernaut, so time to do it.
Fringe. How would you say his name?
Fringe.
Just really.
Like the English word fringe.
Yeah, fringe.
Yeah.
I didn't think it was spelled that way. I thought it was an extra something in there. Oh well, whatever. We got so much time to talk about stuff. What you want to talk about? Cart's jokes, how they're amazingly bad or amazingly good.
They're keeping the cast alive. Why does Luna hate Venomancer so much? He keeps trying to poison Nova. Nova!
Jeez, Cap. Jeez, dude. Oh, yeah, that Dad 2 jokes. I think those were used in another cast before, too. I was listening to some of them. They're okay.
Nahaz and I had a crazy long pause action that I pulled out a couple of those.
What else did you pull out?
I pulled out my dick, Rio, right on
show. Wow, you should have said you pulled out of the race for mayor or something. Jeez. Oh, man. Whoa, this got intense fast.
Who did Slardar send flowers to? His crush.
I'm thinking of...
His Slytherin crush.
Slytherin. I just thought of the word Slytherin because it's a dirty word you could use it for.
Did you giggle all the way through Harry Potter every single time Slytherin came up?
No. Just when Snake said it.
No. I am not looking those up. That one was legitimately on me. Just coming up with it in my head.
That was like an easy
word. That was the answer, though, wasn't it? Easy.
Her crush.
It should be the answer if it wasn't.
It's not dramatic enough.
So, Ryu, happy you joined me for tonight's casting. Why was the game paused? I want to hear this joke. I would love to hear this joke. I need to know the answer, Cart. Please tell me.
Oh, no, it sucked. I thought it was going to be epic.
To make Cap angry and me to tell bad jokes. Yeah, that sounds about right.
Thought it was so we could all go insane or something.
Yeah. All right,
I will. Wait. What was it? What did it start off with again? Why did the game get paused?
Yeah, why did the game get paused?
All right. I get a minute at least, maximum. Let's see. Why was the game paused?
I just decided to make a dead silence to make it as hard as possible for you to make up the joke.
I know. I was like, I was going to say something with dead silence in the joke, too. I was like, why was the game paused? Because it got silent. Whoa, some, I don't know, some stupid. I was trying to think of something. That's all I could think about is silence during that whole thing. It worked. Your mojo threw me off.
Could have at least used Chronosphere somewhere in there. I don't know.
Oh. Could have used Global Silence?
No, that's mute, not pause.
I don't know. Why was the game paused? Because Capitalist is getting ravaged at the studio?
What? What?
What? Nothing? I don't know. Hey man, casters need pauses too, dude. There could be stuff on your end.
We rarely do. I've asked for a pause like twice in my life. And that has always been in like after draft at beginning of the game when nothing has happened.
No betting though, so it wouldn't make sense. I thought he said what do you call
cat,
it?
Dog pile. I don't know. Cat pile. Meowton. Damn it.
Meowton. I want a dog.
Why is Kunkka a pirate, Ryu?
Because he likes Moby Dick.
What?
What? What?
I said pirate, not butt pirate. Jesus.
Moby Dick. There's a whale. You go hunt whales.
I know what Moby Dick is. Oh, hey, now I found the one Cart was talking about. Who did Flowers send flowers to? His slithering crush. Damn, I'm so good. Did you hear about Naga killing Tidehunter?
Was it? I don't know. No. What happened?
The answer is one of her abilities. Come on. Come on, Ryu. You can do this.
Can you say the thing again?
Did you hear about Naga Siren killing a Tidehunter?
Kraken, sleep. Can I put them two and two together?
No,
Kraken,
there are
sleep.
Only four abilities for Naga Siren.
Oh, I thought you could use Kraken and stuff too.
No.
Oh, okay. Sleep, ensnare, Riptide. Oh, it's because the Riptide came in.
Riptide.
Oh, Riptide. Oh, I still don't get it. I got it eventually, but I didn't get it until you told me. Fuck.
Yo, Cap, did you hear about the actress that got stabbed the other day, Reese with or something?
Spoon?
Yeah, I'm trying to think of what the joke is here. Shit, I think I've heard this before, too.
Oh, she got stabbed by a spoon. Oh.
Okay. With her spoon. Yeah. I've heard that one before. God damn it.
I think I've given up on life. So when are we getting custom games, Cap? I really want to know, because we've had them for about a year now. It's just that they've halted after a month or two of creation, just because of the limitations that were put on them. So we didn't see a Diretide, and we didn't see a Frostivus, but we got to see the Yearbeast. So did they have Source 2 done for Yearbeast, or did they go back to do something else? All right, well, it's over Cap's head, and back to Cart Dota, guys.
I actually wasn't listening to you.
Oh,
I'm sorry. It's my bad.
It's fine.
I got distracted by something.
Probably watching porn. How do I feel about techies? If he thinks it's the worst hero in the game, I think I heard him cast too. Like, and he said Techies is like the most useless hero in the game. I said that's not even true at all. I think he's probably like fifth worst hero.
Oh my god, somebody's actually watching this.
Why? Are they putting stuff on Twitter?
Tobias actually tweeted us. I'm laughing way more than I should at these jokes. Well, thanks, man. I honestly don't expect anybody to be anybody to actually be listening to us anymore by this point. It's been like a really long pause.
I mean, it's been 100 million long pauses.
Yeah.
Thanks to you, this is all me, man. Yeah, okay, this guy's taking all the credit. Kicked from cast.
He tweeted at all three of us.
I know, I'm talking about Cart, though.
Oh,
I know it's all been him, but
you.
he's just bragging now.
I'm too tired. Oh, did Chen know he was in love with Enchantress?
No.
Because the further he got from her, the more it hurt. There's my
Yay, reconnection!
Laugh.
Woohoo! All right, no more cap jokes.
What did Tiny say to Wisp when Wisp saved him? I owe you one!
Wow.
Alright, that was more Tidehunter voice than Tiny. Yeah, I don't play enough Tiny.
Oh, Ranger's
dead. Hey, Jolem's dead. Bye bye.
That BKB though. Where's the Venswap? Venswap!
Nope.
Damn it.
This isn't, they don't even have a Venge. I actually was thinking there was a Vengeful Spirit in the game. I hate you so much. That's how lost in this game I am now after that 20-minute pause. Because I don't even know what heroes are playing anymore.
I knew you would get confused. Oh, man. I did it before, too, in one of our other casts like that.
Yeah, I remember that.
Oh, this is too easy now.
All right. Game number one of the best of three between Spin to Win and Immortal Mode On. Immortal Mode On are on the precipice of being able to win this game. It seems 24-9, 31 minutes in. They've got about a 11,000 gold lead, 3011, whatever. That's a number now. 15,000 experience lead as well. They're just looking to breach the base. Dire's middle
tower is under attack. Chip, 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 chip.
Did Spin to Win have a Juggernaut in their game? I can't remember. Clockwork? What did he jump? Oh, he jumped down here. King Ark, well, that's not what you wanted. Meg comes in, but the Orchid is too much. Meanwhile, the Omni Slash bounces on Jolem. They are able to get the clap, which slows them down enough for Maiden to finish mob. Now the BKB activated goes for the Witch Doctor, chasing him down while Sogard is left to die. Spin to Win, only left with now their Wind Ranger, who's a bit under-farmed anyway. But even if she was farmed, she wouldn't be able to take on this team, 1v5. So that should be our first set of racks down in game number one.
It should be more than just that. I think Jug's Healing Ward just came back up, so that's easily two lanes of rats. I don't know if I have enough for three. It'll be close, but... yeah, this is pretty much over. GG should be called hopefully shortly here after that pause. The game lasted, I think, yeah, we had longer pauses in the game lasting this time. And well, you could say this was an easy 70-minute game for, I'm not even going to say their name anymore. Mortally immortal. Fucking, this name is going to be the death of me.
Immortal Mode On.
I can't get the mode on the second thing. Like, I can say immortal in my head, I just can't remember the second word, and it's killing me. Oh my goodness, this Queen of Pain's gold is killing me too.
Worthy tribute. Assault Cure asks for the Brewmaster!
Yes!
God damn it, Ryo! God damn it, I hate you! Why didn't you just say Assault Cure asks? Why didn't you just say BKB so I could go with my original prediction, which was Assault Cure asks?
Technically, we called it three times that he was going to go Assault Karas because we knew they were going to win a team fight.
Yeah, I said it, and then we said it twice after that.
No, we said that it was going to happen, so technically we're right, even though we did the other things for trolls. So we're fine, man. We're fine.
Scotty for the Juggernaut. By the way, what the hell is this set? I keep looking at it. The mask. Blades Runner?
It doesn't even look like he was able to run. How do you even... it's like he's kicking through his dress. How can you run so fast if you have a kimono on or
God,
whatever?
That's a good question. A kimono that goes like all the way down to the bottom of his legs.
Yeah, you didn't think of that, did you, Valve? Yeah.
Yeah, Valve, give me some realism in my cosmetics. Meanwhile, all these goddamn heroes are operating with like masks that cover up their eyes. Jump in, up the Witch Doctor ultimate going out, but it's just not doing any damage. Bane actually is like taking nothing as he's life stealing outside of that one. Omni Slash bounce around, doesn't get enough bouncing to finish off Sogard. The ultimate will take him out though. Mr. Ling also goes down, Queen of Pain with the triple kill and Spin to Win. We'll call GG despite the buyback on Wind Ranger. They said it's all done. We're out.
out of the tournament? 2-0? Okay, well played. Immortal mode on. There we go. I got it right. And game three. Deciding. No, I'm just kidding. All right, so that was the first game there. And, well, it just came down to that top team fight. Maybe you guys forgot. I know I forgot what happened in this game. But we saw Spin to win, lose that team fight top. And it was just pretty much over. Scharfik definitely MVP this game. And really well played coming in from him. A lot of dunks and nice plays. And yeah, Kingar definitely 8-1 is obviously MVP candidate too. So,
all right, guys, we're going to take a short break and we'll be back with game number two, Spin to Win versus, apparently, Spin to Win, but it's actually Immortal Mode on.